I'm Jeremy Jack. I'm gastroenterologist and interventional endoscopist in the Limoges University Hospital in France. And I will speak about my paper entitled Endoscopic Ultrasound Guide Cholecystectomy with Electrocautery Enhanced Lumen Apposing Stent, a Retrospective Analysis. As you all know, endoscopic ultrasound guide biliary drainage is an alternative to percutaneous biliary drainage in case of malignant biliary obstruction and failure of ERCP. Recently, new electrocautery enhanced lumen apposing metal stents that allow for endoscopic anastomosis has become available for use in US cholecystectomy. It could probably facilitate the procedure. We have decided to perform a retrospective study of all US cholecystectomy procedures that were performed in France between April 2016, that was the beginning of the commercialization of the stent in France, and August 2017. We recruited 52 consecutive patients. The etiology of the distal biliary obstruction was, of course, distal pancreatic adenocarcinoma in more than 80% of the patients. The technical success rate of the US cholecystectomy with the axial stent was high, around 90%, and the clinical success rate was 100%. The procedure duration was short, around 10 minutes. Only two patients presented a shortened complication that were linked to US cholecystectomy. In univariate analysis, the small diameter of the common bile duct and not using a Purkinje current or performed first a puncture of the bile duct with inserting a guide wire were significant risk factors for technical failure. This study is the second largest retrospective study of US cholecystectomy using this new stent. It's a well-designed stent with electrocautery and apposition ability that allow for fast, safe, and efficacious US cholecystectomy. We found only one directly related complication, that was the bleeding. The second related complication were another bleeding that were linked to the pre-cuts that were performed before the US cholecystectomy. We find that a small diameter of the common bile duct was a risk factor in an univariate analysis of technical complication. However, it is possible, even if it is difficult, to perform direct US cholecystectomy in bile duct around 12 to 13 mm. When the diameter of the bile duct is greater than 20 mm, US cholecystectomy with a 6 mm axial stent is not more technically challenging than US drainage for peripancreatic collection. Contrary to the study that were published in Endoscopy 2016, performed by Kunda et al., that reported 56 patients that were drained with US cholecystectomy with the axial stent, in the study of Kunda, all the participants were well-recognized international experts of the field in US cholecystectomy. In our study, only four operators were considered to be experts in USBD. And we define as experts in USBD physicians that have already performed more than 20 USBD procedures. 44% of the procedures were performed by operators that had only very little expertise in USBD, with a median of 5 USBD procedures. And this data is very important for us. It reinforces the results about the simplification of USBD using this new stent. In conclusion, for us, US cholecystectomy with the electrocautery enhanced lumen apposing metal stent is efficacious and safe in distant malignant obstruction of the common bile duct disease in case of ERCP failure. This new device considerably facilitates US cholecystectomy and could be proposed as the first option in case of ERCP failure for distal tumoral obstruction. Of course, we need randomized prospective study to compare this procedure with other USBD procedures, in particular to compare this procedure to hepaticogastrostomy. But also, for us, this procedure is so efficacious and so safe that we need urgent prospective comparative study to compare US cholecystectomy to classic transtumoral stenting with ERCP in case of distal malignant obstruction of the common bile duct.